I'm going to give you the ultimate comparison between WordPress and Webflow right now. I'm a web designer and SEO specialist and have used both WordPress and Webflow for search engine optimization and website development. Which platform is best for you or your company might be totally different than which is best for another. Both platforms can make incredibly, incredibly profitable websites. So it's more so which one you think you can utilize best for your expertise. Let's dig in and see if we can find the right one for you. I'm going to go through 12 different aspects that are important for web developers and compare Webflow and WordPress with them. Feel free to skip ahead to a particular section, or you can watch the whole thing. Up to you. We'll start out with design, because that's pretty important, right? Both WordPress and Webflow allow you to build completely custom websites from scratch. With Webflow, you can purchase a pre-built template, or you can just start from scratch and build from your imagination. WordPress, on the other hand, gives you three options. You can custom code the website, use a pre-built template theme, or you can use a page builder. For the sake of this video, I'm only going to be talking about using WordPress with template themes and page builders, since that's the most common use today. So while both WordPress and Webflow allow for completely custom designs, the interfaces are different and it really depends on the personal preference which one's best. Webflow probably has a leg up on how much customization you can do, but the WordPress page builders are just lagging behind. The cost structure of Webflow and WordPress are different. Webflow's website pricing model is quite simple. They also offer account plans and e-commerce plans, but for now, let's just look at the three main plans. The basic plan is $12 a month, CMS is $16 per month, and business is $36 per month. Most companies will go with the $12 or $16 plans, and the main difference is that the CMS plan allows you to create template pages and dynamically import its information to other pages. For example, you could create a blog template page, and then all you have to do in the future to add a blog post is fill in the fields, and the CMS will take care of the rest. WordPress is actually free to use, however, there are other costs. You'll need hosting, which will be anywhere from $3 to $35 a month, a theme or page builder. If you choose to go that route, it'll cost you anywhere from $30 to $200 per year. Some hosting providers will give free SSL certificates, but if yours does not, you'll need to pay an extra $5 to $15 per month. You can easily get by without paying for plugins, but there are some premium plugins that cost money, something to keep in mind. In the end, the cost of WordPress versus the cost of Webflow will be quite similar, contrary to common belief. For Webflow, you'll pay anywhere from $12 to $278 per month. For WordPress, you'll pay anywhere from $3 to $137 per month. Most websites are going to be more towards the bottom of those ranges, though. Search engine optimization. Webflow comes with SEO tools built in. You don't need to install anything, they're just there. WordPress, on the other hand, allows for SEO, but you need to install the correct plugins to accomplish this. The most common plugins for SEO are Yoast SEO, All-in-One SEO Pack, WP Rocket, Auto Optimize, and so many others that I could go on all day talking about. In summary, both WordPress and Webflow allow you to optimize your website for search engines quite easily. It's really just which one you prefer to use. PageSpeed is an important one. Webflow gets an A+ as all their websites are hosted on their Tier 1 content delivery network, Amazon CloudFront. Also, the code of Webflow websites are quite clean to begin with, which makes a noticeable difference for page speed. WordPress is quite the opposite. It's notoriously known to have slow page speed. There are some options to speed up load times, but it's going to be difficult to catch up to Webflow. Some ways to speed up WordPress load times are using fast themes, purchasing hosting from the best providers, and using page speed plugins. Click the link to my article in the description if you want to see the best providers, themes, or plugins for page speed. To give a little more context to the discussion, Brian Dean at Backlinko recently published a study that looked at PageSpeed from different CMS platforms. Not surprisingly, WordPress ranked near the bottom. Webflow is not included in the study, but I'm guessing it would be near the top. Both WordPress and Webflow are set up nicely for adding content and blogging. With Webflow, you can use their CMS plan to dynamically import information to pages. WordPress was originally set up for blogging, so adding content is relatively easy. In the end, Webflow's page builder has more customization capabilities on the blog template page, as well as dynamically importing information to other pages, but WordPress is easier for beginners to start out. Now we're on to third-party plugins and integrations. Webflow does not have an option to install plugins. If you want to use a third-party integration, you will need to add it with custom code. WordPress is built on plugins. I don't think I've ever had a WordPress website without installing at least 5 plugins. They're simply crucial. You can do things like SEO tasks, page speed optimization, anti-spam filtering, contact forms, and so much more. If you don't want to be messing around with any custom code, then WordPress is for you. However, I'm no expert coder, and I manage just fine with adding small pieces of code in Webflow. There's really not much of a comparison when it comes to animations and interactions. Webflow is by far the better option if you want to spice up your website with motion. There are 5 main interaction types that you can use, and there's also another great feature called Lottie, which allows you to integrate After Effects animations into your design quite easily. WordPress allows basic animations upon scrolling into view, but anything past that will probably have to be custom coded or added with a plugin that integrates with a page builder. Webflow comes with a hosting plan which is self-labeled as world-class speed and reliability, and that's for a good reason. As I mentioned earlier, they're set up with AWS servers. Backups and custom forms are included, however, email integration is not. You can use G Suite if you want to add an @domain email address. To use WordPress, you first need to purchase hosting. You can do this through one of the many providers, such as Bluehost, Dreamhost, or InMotion Hosting. There are lots of options for hosting providers and how you want to set it up, and most come with email configuration, but it's best to find one that integrates well with G Suite or Outlook. To summarize, Webflow is already set up with hosting and has great performance, but more customization can be done with WordPress hosting. If you've never used either of these platforms, it'd be nice to know which one is easier to learn before jumping in head first. Webflow does come with a learning curve. The user interface could be a bit intimidating upon first impression. Webflow is best for someone who's familiar with page builders and at least has a basic knowledge of how coding works. For example, the Flexbox is a commonly used setting, but trying to figure it out without any prior knowledge of it would be kind of a mess. There's a reason why WordPress is the most popular website platform on the planet. Beginners use WordPress and experts use WordPress. Some websites are set up with a free theme and only 2 plugins and only used for blogging purposes. Others are using custom page builders, have 25 plugins, and are used for advanced activities such as e-commerce. With that being said, WordPress can still be a little confusing for an absolute beginner. The takeaway is that WordPress is a little easier to learn for beginners. However, the intermediate or expert shouldn't have a difficult time with either of these platforms. Both WordPress and Webflow have e-commerce platforms. The biggest perk of Webflow e-commerce is the ability to customize the shopping cart and the checkout pages to match the rest of the website. It has integrations with PayPal, Stripe, Apple Pay, and Google Pay. WordPress e-commerce is commonly set up with WooCommerce. This plugin is completely free, but you can add additional extensions if needed. WordPress's e-commerce platform is a little easier to use than Webflow for beginners. Webflow's dynamic CMS capabilities are incredibly useful for someone who has practiced with them, but not for the average consumer. Staging is important because it allows you to see the changes you make to a website before you hit publish on the live website. Webflow comes with staging already set up. WordPress has 2 options for staging. If your hosting provider provides a one-click staging option, you can use that. If not, you'll need to set it up manually. Webflow offers a community support forum for technical help as well as direct support through email. WordPress does not offer direct support, but there is a vast amount of information out there as long as you're willing to take the time to sift through all of it. You can always contact your hosting provider, but they're not always very helpful with WordPress support questions unless you're paying an additional charge for it. So now it's time for my opinion. Webflow is better than WordPress in terms of design customization, code cleanliness, and animations. WordPress, however, beats out Webflow with third-party integrations and ease of use for beginners. I see a lot of companies still using WordPress simply because it's more widely known. It can integrate with tools they are already familiar with, and to be fair, that actually makes business sense. Webflow takes some time to learn, and not all business owners will be in favor of taking the time to do so. The end user really doesn't care all that much about which platform you use. Choosing either WordPress or Webflow will not be the deciding factor if your website has a beautiful design or if it ranks number 1 on Google. It's more so which one's easiest for you to use and which will allow you to create the best product for your customer. Which platform do you use? Let me know in the comments below.